there are some most common words that need to be in spoken English. But just by learning words, you cannot speak English anymore. So they must be used, or you must use them. We need to learn how to use it in such a way that is useful to us every day. That means we can use them when we speak English. There are some words I will teach you today that you can use them daily. Start speaking English with these. I hope you can speak English very quickly. Our first word is certain, or we can use sure instead of certain in some cases. For example, I am quite certain. I am quite certain. We can also say, I am quite sure. I am quite sure. I am certain of that. I am certain of that. Here we can also use the word sure instead of certain. I am sure of that. I am sure of that. Grammatically, there is no difference between sure and certain. However, the word sure is more commonly used in spoken English than certain. Moreover, the word certain is used to emphasize the sentence. Let's learn more about it. I am certain that he will come. I am certain that he will come. Here we can also use sure instead of certain. I am sure that he will come. I am sure that he will come. Let's learn more about certain. He has certain rights. He has certain rights. Why are you so certain? Why are you so certain? They are absolutely certain. They are absolutely certain. I am not certain about that. I am not certain about that. Are you quite certain about it? Are you quite certain about it? I was so certain. I was so certain. Our next word is usually. We can also use ordinarily, normally, mostly, generally, commonly, etc. These are all nearest meaning words. Also learn how to use them. For example, I usually walk. I usually walk. Here we can use the word mostly, like I mostly walk. I mostly walk. Ordinarily, he goes to work by bus. Ordinarily, he goes to work by bus. We usually win. We usually win. I don't usually cry. I don't usually cry. I am not usually wrong. I am not usually wrong. I don't normally lie. I don't normally lie. I don't normally do that. Generally. I generally agree with him. I generally agree with him. I generally walk to school. I generally walk to school. I generally have lunch there. I generally have lunch there. Fat people generally sweat a lot. Fat people generally sweat a lot. Perhaps. We can also use maybe, probably. These are all nearest meaning words. There is really no difference between perhaps and maybe. Both words can be used interchangeably. For example, perhaps he will come. Perhaps he will come. Or we can say, maybe he will come. Maybe he will come. Here we used maybe instead of perhaps. It doesn't change the meaning of the sentence. Let's learn some more examples. Perhaps you can help. Perhaps you can help. Or maybe you can help. Maybe you can help. Perhaps that is true. Perhaps that is true. Perhaps it is true. Perhaps I can help you. Perhaps you were right. Perhaps you were right. Our next word is probably. We should probably go. We should probably go. You are probably tired. You are probably tired. You are probably wrong. You are probably wrong. It was probably stolen. It was probably stolen. Briefly. Briefly. We can also use shortly or in short. Briefly means for a short time or in a short space of time. And shortly means soon. Let's learn with some examples. State your case briefly. He will be back shortly. He will be back shortly. The plane crashed shortly after takeoff. The plane crashed shortly after takeoff. They spoke briefly. They spoke briefly. He talked to me briefly. He talked to me briefly. He glanced briefly at the newspaper. He glanced briefly at the newspaper. In some cases, we may use the word in short. For example, in short, I like this. In short, I like this. In short, we must be prepared. In short, we must be prepared. Our next word is undoubtedly. For example, undoubtedly he did it. Undoubtedly he did it. That is undoubtedly true. He is undoubtedly a great player. He is undoubtedly a great player. The paintings are undoubtedly genuine. The paintings are undoubtedly genuine. Learn different words this way. Those are very simple but very handy. Learn to use other words without always using the same word. Learn English this way. Then your confidence will increase and you can speak English very well. I hope this video will help you. See you again with another topic. If you like the video, please comment and if you can share. Stay well and stay with me to learn English.